The mighty lion might be the king of land predators, but that's not why we're here today. Let's jump into the sea. Ocean predators are just as powerful and deadly, but maybe a tad more mysterious. The world's oceans are full of fascinating, beautiful, and sometimes terrifying creatures, and we love it. Some of these powerful predators do not have a taste for human flesh, but of course, there are always exceptions. The ocean is a wild and unpredictable force. That's what makes it so exciting. From killer whales to tiger sharks, from wolffish to leopard seals, we've got the power. Here are the 15 most powerful ocean predators in the world. Number 15. Orcas. Everybody assumes that the top predator in the ocean is the great white shark, but a new study reveals that the massive shark is not the ocean's top apex predator. The title rightly belongs to orcas, also known as killer whales. They weigh up to 6 tons and grow to 23 to 32 feet, and that's almost as long as a school bus. Now that's some kind of power. Though they don't typically attack humans, they have the ability to take down large marine animals, such as sea lions and whales, and even great white sharks. Orcas love their nutrient-rich livers. Yeah, these animals know what they like, and they know how to get it. Scientists have even begun to notice that when orcas enter shark-filled waters, the sharks would leave, and in many cases did not return for months. In particular, in 2009, a team radio tagged 17 sharks around a marine and wildlife refuge off the coast of California. The sharks happily munched on young elephant seals in the waters around the island, which they regularly do between September and December. But when a pod of orcas entered the water for just a couple of hours, the sharks hightailed it out of there and most didn't return that season. Wait for me, guys.
Oh my God, oh my God. Are you kidding me? That was unbelievable.
Before we move on, if you don't smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell today, it, the clown, will appear under your bed tonight. Number 14, the Bobbit Worm. Readers of a certain age will remember the story of Mrs. Lorena Bobbit, who in 1993 made world news for taking a kitchen implement to her abusive husband's lower regions, if you get our drift. So why not name a worm after the infamous Bobbits? In 1996, a lowly and largely overlooked ocean worm was finally bequeathed the common name, the Bobbit Worm. And it's a gnarly little beast found in warmer oceans around the world. This weird worm buries itself into sediment, leaving only its mouth exposed with its huge, scissor-like jaws open wide. 5 antennae protruding from its head act like tripwires. If a fish should accidentally brush past one of them, it has mere milliseconds to flee, and then gotcha! The Bobbit Worm's razor-sharp mouth parts strike with such velocity that prey is sometimes sliced clean in two. A couple inches wide and up to 10 feet long, the Bobbit Worm stays hidden under tropical sands with just its 5 antennae poking out, waiting. When it senses prey from above, it moves with stealth speed and major strength to grab them. It also injects them with a toxin to help break down its food to make it easier to digest. So this isn't just a worm, it's a weapon. A very powerful one. Number 13. Deep sea crocodiles. In 2018, Australian parks and wildlife rangers captured a monster of a crocodile. The beast was 15 feet and 5 inches long and weighed a whopping 1,300 pounds. These deep sea monsters are sometimes referred to as saltwater crocodiles. Unlike alligators or caiman, deep sea crocodiles have functional lingual salt glands for expelling sodium chloride and a fairly impermeable lining to their inner mouth, which makes them inherently hardier than their relatives in seawater. And any good-sized crocodilian can survive a long while without drinking fresh water by satisfying its needs via food and metabolic action. A number of crocodile species readily reside in these habitats, but two are by far most comfortable in marine settings: the American croc and the Indo-Pacific, aka saltwater croc. Highly adaptable, they are excellent swimmers and have often been spotted far out at sea. Classic opportunistic predators, they lurk patiently beneath the surface near the water's edge, waiting for potential prey to stop for a sip of water. And crunch, they'll feed on anything they can get their jaws on, including water buffalo, monkeys, wild boar, and even sharks. Without warning, they explode from the water with a thrash of their powerful tails, grasp their victim, and drag it back in, holding it under until it's all over. Incredible.
Alert! I'm really not that comfortable being so close to him. It's one of...
Number 12. The Great Barracuda. So famous, the legendary rock band, Heart, wrote a song about this powerful fish. The Great Barracuda is amongst the top predators in their environment and uses very highly developed smell and vision senses to locate their prey. When attacking, the Barracuda will charge at fast speed and ram their target. They then unleash the power of their jaws, which allows them to slice through their prey, even those larger than the Barracuda itself. The jaw of the Barracuda is formed in such a way where the upper and lower jaws form rows of teeth. When the jaw closes, this acts like scissors and slices through prey with ease. You do not want to try feeding this wicked fish. Mostly found living on nearshore coral reefs in tropical and subtropical waters, the Great Barracuda lives quite close to the surface of the water. It has, however, been known to take their occasional foray into open water and has been observed as deep as 350 feet. They can grow over 6 feet in length, and the largest known weight was approximately 100 pounds, which means predators are in short supply. However, sharks, Goliath groupers, and even tuna have been known to feed on the smaller adults. The Great Barracuda has no threats except the occasional dolphin or shark. That's no biggie. Number 11. Deep sea anglerfish. National Geographic called these otherworldly terrors from the deep possibly the ugliest animal on the planet. Do you agree? They're a little scary for sure. From their mouth full of razor-sharp, translucent teeth to their dead eyes, these deep sea carnivores are rarely seen alive. So we're really lucky to get to know them. They live several hundred feet below the surface of the ocean, and when one gets caught in a fishing net or washes ashore, it's because it couldn't survive near the shore. Few wonders of the sunless depths appear quite so ghoulish or improbable as anglerfish, creatures that dangle bioluminescent lures in front of needle-like teeth. They're fish that fish. Typically, the rod of flesh extending from the forehead glows at the tip. Anglerfish can wiggle the lure to better mimic living bait. Most species can open their mouths wide enough to devour prey whole, using their fangs not only as daggers, but as bars of a cage. Some can open their jaws and stomach so wide as to trap victims much larger than themselves, although anglerfish are rarely as large as a man's fist. But one specimen from a depth of 2.2 miles off West Africa was a foot and a half long. It was also unusual in having its glowing bait conveniently located inside its enormous mouth. Show off. Number 10. The mantis shrimp. Despite its common name, the mantis shrimp is not actually a shrimp. It's a stomatopod, distantly related to lobsters and crabs, and are some of the most ancient animals on Earth. Their evolution predating the dawn of the dinosaurs by around 170 million years. At first sight, its shell is a stunning kaleidoscope of green, orange, blue, and red, while leopard-like spots adorn its legs. But don't be fooled, this little creature is powerful. It's highly aggressive, territorial, and a creature that doesn't take kindly to strangers. Folded away beneath its body is a pair of lethal, club-like front legs, or dactyls. If threatened, the mantis shrimp can whip out these appendages at speeds of 75 feet per second. That's 50 times faster than the blink of an eye, or about the same as the trajectory of a .22 caliber bullet, and with a force some 100 times that of its weight, making it the strongest self-powered strike by any animal. So put them up. Native to coral reefs and other shallow water habitats in the Pacific and Indian Oceans, the mantis shrimp grows no more than 7 inches long and weighs around 1 pound and 5 ounces, about as heavy as a basketball. Number 9. Tiger shark. The tiger shark is a large, in-charge predator, capable of attaining a length of 16 feet 5 inches. And next to great whites, these powerful sharks have the second highest rate of attacks on humans. Populations are found in many tropical and temperate waters, especially around central Pacific islands. Its name derives from the dark stripes down its body, which resemble a tiger's pattern, but fade as the shark matures. The tiger shark is a solitary, mostly nocturnal hunter. But strangely, it's notable for having the widest food spectrum of all sharks, with a range of prey that includes crustaceans, fish, seals, birds, squid, turtles, sea snakes, dolphins, and even other smaller sharks. But what gets people's attention is some of the wacky stuff that shows up in the tiger shark's stomach. Rubber boots, bags of charcoal, boat cushions, hubcaps, pets, raincoats, handbags, cow's hooves, deer antlers, lobsters, a suit of armor, sneakers with legs attached. This list could go on for a while. Scientists are still determining whether such a diet means that the tiger shark is primitive and unevolved in its willingness to eat anything, or whether being able to eat anything is a smart evolutionary defense. We choose the latter. They're obviously geniuses. Number 8. Portuguese man-o-war. The Portuguese man-o-war may look like a bloated jellyfish, but it's actually a siphonophore, a bizarre group of animals that consist of colonies made up of dozens, hundreds, or even thousands of genetically identical individual creatures. Go team! These colonies spend a lot of time floating at the water surface, and when the gas bladder is expanded, it looks and acts a bit like a sailboat. In the age of sailing, many European navies used tall warships loaded with cannons and propelled by three masts. British sailors took to calling this kind of vessel a man of war, and so this creature got its name. The odds of being killed by a Portuguese man of war are pretty slim, but just because deaths are rare doesn't mean you should touch one. On February 11th, 2018, 204 people in Hollywood, Florida were treated for stings, which can lead to red welts on the skin, muscle cramps, elevated heart rates, and vomiting. Still, the creatures can kill. Of course they can. One unlucky victim suffered a full cardiovascular collapse and died after getting too close to a man-o-war in eastern Florida back in 1987. More recently, a woman swimming off of Sardinia was stung by one and died of anaphylactic shock. So know before you go. Number 7. Atlantic Wolffish. The wolffish is a powerful, elongated fish with a gnarly grin. Its fearsome set of teeth are used for mashing up shellfish and sea urchins, and the whole of the inside of the mouth is made up of grinding molars. So there's no escape. Atlantic wolffish are voracious predators, and the large head, powerful jaws, and large canine teeth are all used to hunt and eat hard-bodied or spiny invertebrates, such as crabs, large marine snails, etc. So the teeth gotta do their job. These fish are restricted to the cold waters of the North Atlantic Ocean, and their blood contains several natural compounds that prevent it from freezing in such frigid temperatures. Atlantic wolffish are good table fare, and throughout its range, it's fished by both recreational fishers and occasional commercial net fishers. But over the last several decades, scientists have observed steep declines in its numbers. In the United States, it's considered a species of concern. Although they can occasionally be found in fairly shallow water, they're more frequently seen below 60 feet, lying with their heads protruding from holes. A decent torch is very useful for spotting them, as they usually withdraw into the hole as they are approached. Number 6. Giant Pacific Octopus. The giant Pacific octopus is known to grow as large as 600 pounds and 30 feet. That's a whole lot of big, with 8 really long arms full of tentacles. Guinness World Records list the biggest as 600 pounds with an arm span of 32 feet. That's a whole other level of big. These octopus prey upon shrimp, crabs, scallop, cockles, snails, clams, lobster, fish, and other octopus. Food is procured using its suckers and then bitten using its tough beak. It has also been observed to catch spiny dogfish sharks up to 4 feet long while in captivity. Additionally, consumed carcasses of this same shark species have been found in giant Pacific octopuses in the wild, providing strong evidence of these octopus preying on small sharks in their natural habitat. In May of 2012, a wild giant Pacific octopus was photographed attacking and drowning a seagull, demonstrating that this species is not above eating any available source of food within its size and range, even birds. Fortunately, if left alone, these giants are fairly chill. Not exactly zero chill, but fairly chill. Number 5. Hagfish Swarm. Hagfish, the eel-like, slime-emitting wrigglers of the seafloor, just can't get enough of decaying corpses, like zombie worms. Just watch a swarm of them feed. When they come across a dead sea creature, they snuggle their sinewy bodies down into its cavities and stay there, writhing blissfully. They eat their way out of the carcass. When they can't pack enough flesh into their tentacle-lined mouths, hagfish absorb the carcass's nutrients right through their skin. Hagfish clean their plate. If a dead animal falls to the bottom of the sea, it's typically a hagfish swarm that gets there first, burrowing their entire bodies into the carcass. They have zero chill. Growing up to 18 inches in length, hagfish have some truly bizarre features, such as eyes that cannot see, 4 hearts, up to 15 sets of gills, and can change their gender season to season. To dodge predators, hagfish instantly produce loads of mucus and thin protein fibers through glands lining their bodies. When the slime makes contact with seawater, it expands into a transparent, sticky goo, filling the gills and choking its attacker, making the hagfish almost impossible to devour. Number 4. Leopard Seal. Leopard seals do not play well with others, because they're kind of salty, so to speak. Generally, they hunt alone and are typically never seen with more than 1 or 2 individuals at a time. Due to their exceptionally nasty demeanor and solitary nature, however, little is known about them. Scientists are still trying to figure them out, but we know they're big and they're powerful. Female leopard seals, the larger of the two sexes, can reach weights of 1,300 pounds and grow to lengths of up to 10 feet. This specialized, streamlined body shape is excellent for propelling them through the water at speeds of up to 25 miles per hour. But they are cute. The ends of the leopard seal's mouths are permanently curled upward, creating the illusion of a smile or menacing grin. However happy they may be to see you, they're potentially aggressive animals that will always be keeping an eye out for the next meal. In the rare occasion that they haul out on land, they'll defend their personal space by issuing a warning growl at anything that comes too close. So give the leopard seal plenty of room. Number 3. The stonefish. Sometimes you can't see what's beneath you while you swim in the ocean. The stonefish can be superbly camouflaged. They are masters at it, often looking like an encrusted rock or lump of coral, displaying colors like brown or gray and may have patches of yellow, orange, or red, blending seamlessly into its environment. And they're fast. It usually waits for prey, like tiny fish or crustacea, to swim past, and then strikes with incredible speed. High-speed camera equipment is required to record the feeding of this species. They usually live on rubble or coral bottoms, often under rocks or ledges, but are also known to be able to bury in sand and use their large pectoral fins. It's the most venomous fish in the world. The stonefish has 13 stout spines in the dorsal fin, which can inject a highly toxic venom causing intense pain, believed to have killed many Pacific and Indian Ocean islanders. As long as their surrounding areas remain moist, stonefish can survive up to 24 hours by absorbing oxygen through their skin. This is often seen during retreating tides, which leave them partially exposed. So look out and watch your step. Number 2. Polar bear, the Arctic Ocean hunter. Ah yes, these mighty giants. Polar bears spend most of their lives on the sea ice of the Arctic Ocean, depending on the ocean for their food and habitat, the only bear species to be considered marine mammals. The polar bear is a hypercarnivorous bear whose native range lies largely within the Arctic Circle, encompassing the Arctic Ocean, its surrounding seas, and surrounding land masses. An adult male weighs around 700 to 1500 pounds, while an adult female is about half that size. With many body characteristics adapted for cold temperatures, for moving across snow, ice, and open water, and for hunting seals, polar bears are born on land. They spend most of their time on the sea ice. Their scientific name means maritime bear, and derives from this fact. As well as reaching speeds of up to 6 miles per hour in the water, polar bears can swim for long distances and steadily for many hours to get from one piece of ice to another. Their large paws are specifically adapted for swimming, which they'll use to paddle through the water while holding their hind legs flat like a rudder. But don't let that white fur and sweet face fool you. Number 1. Great White Shark. You've reached the most powerful ocean predator on our list, the great white shark. It's hard to imagine a 2,000-pound animal launching itself out of the water while hunting, but the great white shark does just that. This spectacular behavior is called breaching, and great white sharks breach in order to catch fast-moving prey like seals. Swimming fast at the surface, sharks can reach 40 miles per hour and fly 10 feet into the air. However, breaching is relatively rare because the shark has to use so much energy to propel itself. The great white shark can be found in the coastal surface waters of all the major oceans. It's notable for its size, with larger female individuals growing to 20 feet and 4,200 to 5,000 pounds. The lifespan of great white sharks is estimated to be as long as 70 years or more, well above previous estimates, making it one of the longest-lived cartilaginous fish currently known. Great white sharks can swim at speeds of 16 miles per hour for short bursts and to depths of 3,900 feet. The great white shark has no known natural predators other than, on very rare occasions, the killer whale, and is responsible for more recorded human bite incidents than any other shark. Ever seen the movie Jaws? That was 15 of the most powerful ocean predators in the world. Thanks for watching.